Praise the Lord. This is
hallelujah.
Thank you, brother. You know what that is? The Bible, he's exactly right. The Bible says it's a command. When you hear somebody say, praise the Lord, that's not the praise. The praise comes after. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's an instruction. It's a command to do something. In Matthew chapter 7 and verse 20, we're still continuing on in the series of the two principles of the kingdom. There are two principles in the kingdom by which everything is gauged. Everything. And that more and more people are coming into the understanding, the enlightenment, all across the board. Not just people who believe exactly like we believe, but people of all walks, all denominations, all kinds of creed and color are coming into the illumination and the understanding of the first principle, and that is the principle of love.
Hallelujah.
And we must understand that either we are operating in the principle of love, or by default, we are operating in the principle of rebellion. It's just automatic. Rebellion. Principle of rebellion. Matthew 7:20. Wherefore by their fruits ye shall know them. Not everyone who says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Let me just preface that right, or iterate that. Which is in heaven. The action is going to be something that is normal in heaven. Okay, I'm going to say that again.
Amen.
But he that doeth the will of my Father, what is the will of the Father? It's not something that's here. Will of the Father and purpose are two different things.
Amen.
Most people think that their purpose-driven life, oh, I found God's will. Two different things. People in the world find their purpose and understand their purpose. A mother who does a good job raising children recognizes her purpose as a maternal covering for her children, whether she be just or unjust. A father who provides for his family, whether he be just or unjust, has found his purpose of being a father. And we all know that not everybody understands, especially those two levels of purpose, not everybody understands that. But there is a difference in the will of the Father. Okay, you know the scripture that I quote all the time, and I don't know if it has truly sunk into the spirit realm of each one of you, but the Bible says, in every stinking thing, give thanks. For this is the purpose, no, the will of the Father. What is the will? The will is the testament. It is the standard of faith, period. It doesn't change. That's the foundation. That's the principle. That's the gauge. In everything, give thanks. And what do most of us do? In everything, we complain, we murmur, we gripe, we bellyache.
Yes. Come on.
Instead of learning how to be thankful, because church, everybody knows everything. There's a silver lining in every situation.
Yes.
Listen, don't become what you hate. Don't become who and what you hate in others. Because, well, you just understand, they've done this, they've done that, they've hurt me here, they've hurt me there, and they offended me. Get over it! In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God.
Amen.
Life is tough for everybody.
Amen.
I don't care if you're Donald Trump.
Yes.
Yes. in serving in the nursery.
Amen.
Whatever you're doing, there's always something that's trying to pull you down and bring you down. But you've got to learn how that the will of the Father, and the only way you can operate in the will of the Father and have that attitude of gratitude in everything is to have love. You know what? I could be really upset because this crazy thing up here, but I love people. I love everybody around me. I'm not going to, it bends me a little out of shape a little bit, but then I say, you know what? It's just not worth it. There's a lot of valuable things in my house. Things, I mean, candelabras, things that I bought at Neiman Marcus that are expensive things. And as my children were growing, or mostly Carrington, because Catherine was just an angel, and Carrington came along and was like, bam, bam. And he broke some things. He'd look at me like, sorry, Deco, baby. That's just stuff.
Amen.
I can buy more stuff. Does that mean we don't care for what we have? Of course not. I've taught my children that they need to value what God has blessed them with. But when things start falling apart, whatever, you got to learn how to praise Him when your washer goes out. When you got to go to the laundromat, be thankful you got a laundromat. You don't have to go down to the river and beat the dirt out of your clothes. Help us, Lord. Be thankful. Well, it takes quarters. We'll be thankful when you got quarters. There's two principles in this kingdom. You're either operating in love or you're operating in rebellion. You're either in the principle of love or you're operating in the principle of rebellion. God placed in each human being the power to choose life or death. Life is love. Comes from the giver of life. Life is associated with love, and death is associated with rebellion. Broken focus is the cause of every man's failure. The moment that you get your eyes on the problem and the circumstances and poor little me, you start falling apart. You will lose. And just FYI, Psalm 37 verse 19 says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord overcomes them all. I shared with the congregation on Thursday evening because a lot of people have looked at me and said, well, God, doctor, you've been through hell and back. What's the difference? You're sitting there preaching at me that life is a sequence of choices. The quality of your life is contingent upon the consistency of right choices. Right choices equal right results. Wrong choices equal wrong results. Well, what did you do wrong, Dad, doctor, to have all the bad things happen to you? There's a difference. When God tests you, and when you, by your choices, bring craziness upon your life. Here's the difference. You got to get this. You must get this principle. When God tests you, at the end of the test, guess what? There's always promotion. There's always increase. There's always harvest. When you, by your stupid choices, go through hardship, at the end of it, you got less than. You're left with nothing. You're left standing there going, oh my God, you hit rock bottom. But when God puts you, because I'm going to tell you, many are the afflictions. Many. Mary was talking about this morning, that God never promised it was going to be an easy life. And how many times have you, think about it, how many times has it come out of your mouth? I just wish one good thing would happen. Excuse me, well, what the heck world are you living in? You woke up this morning. What do you mean? You're just one good thing. Your kids are alive and well and blessed. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Well, but poor little, you don't understand. Poor little me, and I lost this and I lost that. Well, listen, enough with the losing. Yes. You're in charge of you following in line with God's destiny for your life.
Yes.
I know we say we create our own destiny, But really, God predestined us. He says, I know the plans I have for you. It's to bless you and to prosper you.
Amen.
Now, how quickly we get to that place of prosperity depends on our choices and how many times we rebel against God. We either in the principle of, because if you're in love, how many of you have ever been in love?
Amen.
You've been in love, and you know when you're in love, it's just like, Y'all are wrong. Some of you husbands and wives did not raise your hands.
I did.
I didn't say, are you in love? I just said, have you been in love?
Yes.
Because I'm not going to put you on the spot right now. Because right now you may not be in love. Sometimes you ain't even in life.
Amen.
But you know when you're crazy, crazy in love,
crazy.
You cannot see straight. It's like nothing bothers you. It's like they can do no harm. It's like they're just, oh my God, he's so gorgeous. Oh, she is so fine. But what happens when she starts, when fine goes to she's starting to sag and she after the baby and the baby weight doesn't want to come off. Hello?
Bring us out, Doctor.
But okay, so we know where how things can get. But let's go back to that crazy love.
Amen.
Where we are so blind in love. Love is blind. Does not see all the flaws.
Amen.
So what happens? We slip out of that state of mind, of that zone, and we immediately walk into, and what is it? It's resistance. Did I hear somebody say truth? Come on, give me something. Thank you. The moment that we start backing up, we start resisting, and resistance is a connection to rebellion. Because God will tell you, just turn the other, you all heard me say, I have turned every cheek I got, this cheek, that cheek, I don't know how many more cheeks I got. And yet Christ told Peter, how many times should I forgive? You know why he asked the question? Because we get so super religious and so self-righteous that we say, well, I have already forgiven him 20 times today. Well, Jesus said, forgive him 70 times 7.
Amen.
I forgot what we calculated. That turned out to be every few seconds you had to forgive the person in one 24-hour period. In other words, just live in a state of forgiveness. I'm talking about the principle of love. Because if you're not operating like that, I'm talking about, come on.
Amen.
Because we get so tangled up in our mess that we lose sight of. I mean, think about it. How many people have gotten divorces, and when they get to the divorce court, they hate each other. But at one point, they vowed before God and witnesses. Will you take this man to be your lawful husband? I do. Do you solemnly swear that you will love this woman? Does Christ love the church? Oh, yes.
It's good, doctor.
And then down the road, things begin to unravel. Let me tell you something. Love is patient. Love is kind. But I want you to know, God's love is jealous. The Bible says His name is jealous. There's a name of God that He has. It's called Yahweh Jealous. Because He says, I will have no other gods, none, period, ever. I am that I am, the end, period.